time attack requires working lights. Why? It was a bit of news for me as well, but apparently when you're on a hot lap, you switch them on so other people in front, when you catch up with them, know that you're on a hot lap so they can let you pass. Problem is, they may look like lights, but they're not lights. And we absolutely have no space because of my piping and also the pump in there. So what are we gonna do? Obviously I sold the old ones, so I had to go and buy some crappy ones from eBay. But it's okay, we're gonna do something with them. As you can see, it doesn't really fit. So the plan is completely gut them, cut everything on the inside, and I ordered some LED lights, really powerful lights that will literally sit inside, and it would kind of look like a standard headlight, but it won't be. Essentially it will be a headlight blank with LED behind it. So let's get to it. I got a job in the valley, but today I didn't go. Wonderful. You can see everything behind it. Listen, doesn't matter. We will manage to work with it. A few moments later. I want to have an air duct in here now. Before it was in a bumper, I had three holes cut out. I don't like that. It just doesn't look very neat. So we're gonna have a nice air vent in here. So for this, what we need to do, the plan is, I don't know if it's been done like this before or that's the correct way of doing it, but that's how I'm doing it. Made a template, happy with the position. Cut the shape out, put the tape on the inside, put the tape on the outside. Use expanding foam, build up the whole sort of area. Then cut the diameter hole that I want in there and then start shaping the whole shape. So when I'm happy with the complete shape, prime it, paint it so it's all nice, and that becomes a negative mold. Then we put carbon fiberglass on the inside and make a mold. Then we take that thing off, then we take all of the foam out and whatever and prep this for paint, and then from that we make an insert that goes inside the thing. Hopefully that's how it's supposed to be done and it will work, but I'm not sure. Don't quote me on that. So let's cut this one first. I got a wife at the house, but she got no love for me. That's what it looks like right now. I guess it's all dry. So now let's start shaping it. So, air vent. I really like how it turned out. It's nice and smooth. So now we have to make a plug. Basically, we put the release wax, then we put lots of fiberglass in here, let it dry, and then we, theoretically, we take it out, and then the negative will be the mold thingy bob for making the thing, and then we'll put it back and a couple of rivets and bish bash bosh. Let's get to it. next day. All of the materials used in this video I buy from easycomposites.co.uk. Right now I'm looking for pattern coat primer. It is specially formulated high build polyester resin system designed for fast and easy surfacing of composite patterns. Basically, you apply it, you can sand it, and then you can polish it to mirror finish. And after applying your favorite release agent, you can layer it with reinforcement like carbon fiber or carbon Kevlar. Link to easycomposites.co.uk is in the description. As far as I know, this thing is very simple to use. We have a main component, pattern coat primer. We need to mix 2% catalyst ratio. So if we have 100 ml of this, we need 2 ml of the hardener catalyst. I reckon 100 ml is probably more than enough, isn't it? So basically 2%, we need two and a half grams. So 24, 25. Oopsie, a little bit more than we were supposed to have. Oh well. And then we mix thoroughly. Make sure that all the corners have been reached. Wow, that smells fruity. Now we apply thick coats. The next morning. So now we have the special coat primer dry. It took almost 24 hours. Like I said, a never-ending story with this sanding. It's looking really, really good. I can see now how it can actually polish. I tried a little bit with a 320 grit here, and this will polish to a mirror finish. So now I think I'm gonna apply some 120, flatten it all down. There's a few ridges in places, and then 320, and possibly do another coat, wait another 12 hours, sand it, polish it, and then we will be able to apply some sexy carbon Kevlar. Here we are, after the first coat of primer and sanding. This is extremely smooth. I'm really liking this. It definitely needs another coat, and hopefully this will be the last coat. It goes on thick, and now we'll be able to sand it. And as long as we are not gonna break away through the coat into the filler, then we're good to go. So let's apply another one. Let's wait another 24 hours and we're good. Day
four. Now we're ready for production of some composite materials. I'm super excited about this. I'm glad I finally decided to do this. I already pre-cut all of the materials I'm going to be using. So we're using carbon Kevlar as an outer shape layer, so it will look like this on the outside, and the normal 2x2 200 gram twill for reinforcement. Now we need to decide how much resin we're going to use. So for that we need to actually weigh all of the material. So we have 70 grams. According to instructions by Easy Composites, you use roughly the same amount of resin to your weight of material, plus some of stuff that's left in the pot and stuff like that. Can't even talk, sorry. So I guess we can use 100 mil. Let's be safe, let's do 120 mil. because the ratio is 100 to 30, for 100 grams of resin, we need 30 grams of hardener. That will give us 130, where close to doubling what the capacity we need. So let's... A tiny little bit more, 31 grams. But I don't think this will make too much of a difference. By the way, I still have those t-shirts, different colors. Also hoodies, I have all the sizes, small, medium, large, and extra large. I mean, why not? If you like what I do, if you like some of the videos that I produce for you guys, and you would like to support my channel, yeah, this is not really a money-making exercise. This is basically helping me with certain materials and stuff, so link is in the description. Okay, I should have explained a little bit clearly. There are three different types of carbon fiber or whatever composite processes. The one I'm gonna do here is wet lay. Essentially, it's the same as fiberglass. You apply resin, you put a layer of this, resin, layer of this, and let it dry at room temperature. Another type is resin infusion. Is the same principle, but you apply all of the layers, and then you put a bag, and then you put a little thing, and then it infuses, sucks the air out, and then sucks all the resin, so it infuses. And the third one is prepreg. Basically, you buy the sheets that are already saturated with resin, and then you apply it the same way, put a bag over it, create vacuum, and then you cure it in an oven. We're using the simplest of ways. So we have our mold, as you can see, has been covered with a special primer, and then it's been sanded with 800 wet grit, and then it's been polished, so it's extremely smooth. Also, I had to apply chemical release agent 6 different times, so the actual product doesn't stick to our mold. So the first thing to do is you apply your resin. Always apply resin first onto the mold. We take our first material. You have to make sure, because it's very easy to transfer some of the hairs underneath. I probably should have hoovered, cleared this area a bit better. And then we apply our material onto the mold itself. By the way, this resin is odorless. It absolutely does not smell of anything, which is wonderful, because the kits that I used to buy for fiberglass, oh my god, you have to wear a mask and everything, and then you're walking around like a happy jolly Roger all day long because you have your dose of...
midnight.
Okay, I think it's dry. Remove the peel ply, and the surface is really nice. So let's try and separate it. I don't know if it's gonna work.
At the house, but she got no love for me.
3:28 a.m.
As expected, it's stuck. I cannot separate it in one piece. So we are resorting to cutting the inside mold. I was hoping I could replicate them and make another one, but unfortunately I cannot.
up in the valley, but I doubt I do anymore.
Tomorrow.
Well, as expected, the new part did not come out of the mold in one piece. Well, no, the new part came out in one piece. The mold did not survive. It stuck. I guess it was too many compound curves. But yeah, look at that. I think I'm absolutely in love with composite materials. It's extremely easy to work with them. And I don't think this video served as a tutorial. It was just basically how I did it mine. It's not perfect by any stretch. You can actually see quite a few pinholes in small places. Also, I'm not really sure about this this joining thing. I mean, I've read that you need to fray just so it blends better. But doesn't really matter, because it fits exactly how I wanted it to fit. And it looks really good. So tired of just normal carbon fiber. And this carbon Kevlar will serve as something a little bit different. So yeah, here you go, guys. Now you know how to make carbon Kevlar, and I'm absolutely in love with it. I will be making a lot more parts. Next on the agenda is the canards, again in Kevlar. Then I need to do the separate for my air filter cold intake box, and also the rear floor. It's aluminium right now, but I reckon we can lose another kilo or so by doing it the same way. So watch this space. And as always, guys, don't forget to subscribe, click like, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.